In this session, let us see how and where to use data validation in MS Excel. When it comes to Excel, the details we enter should not contain any incorrect data. We can use the function data validation to ensure the data we enter is accurate. So, let's see how data validation works. In this sheet, I have details of students' names and I need to enter their states. Instead of typing the names, we will create a drop-down list with names of states so that we can choose from the drop-down list. This way, we can avoid typing the spelling incorrectly using short forms, etc. To do that, select the cells where you need the drop-down menu. First, we need to have the list of details we need to appear in the drop-down list. I have the list here in the I column. Go to Data tab, choose Data Validation. In the dialog box that appears for cell range, choose where we want the drop-down to appear. For now, let me choose from B2 to B6 and select OK. Then, in the criteria, we should choose list from a range and then enter a range formula. We need to select the cells which have states names. I have the states name in the I column and I am selecting the cells and then clicking on save. Now we can see a drop-down list method by selecting from a list of entries. Now we will see how to create a drop-down without selecting the range. Go to Data tab, choose Data Validation. In the box that appears in the cell range, choose from B8 to B13. And select OK. Now, let us change the criteria to list of items. Instead of selecting the range, we need to enter the state name continued by comma. For example, Assam, comma, Goa, comma, and Bihar. Now let us uncheck this option for show drop-down list in cell and see what happens. And on invalid data, I am choosing reject input. Next, select checkbox in show validation help text and save. We see that there is no drop-down from B18 to B13. It is because we unchecked the show drop-down list in the cell. When we double-click on the cell, you can see the drop-down list and I am able to select the option. Let's see what happens if I enter a state name which was not in the list. A message box displays asking us to enter a value from the list of items. Hope this is clear. Now let me show you how to create checkboxes. Go to Data, Data Validation. Select the cell range where you need checkbox to be applied. I am selecting from C2 to C11. Then, in the criteria, select the checkbox and save. You can see the checkbox appears here and we can mark it. Today, we have learned how to enter the types of values in the cells using drop-down and checkboxes. These are the commonly used data validation in Excel. This can be very useful when we are entering certain choices in the cells and we can avoid typing the same and easily choose from the given drop-down or checkbox. Thank you.